you talked about two significant and different things. One is India and the potential, and two, the issue of Southeast Asia and the potential for tensions and instability. I think in terms of India, the potential has to some significant degree started to be realized over the last 20 years. I mean, the reforms, the opening up, you've abandoned, you are no longer talking about a Hindu rate of growth. You've made 6-7% a year. You could make even more than that, but this is a lot better than it used to be. And the direction is towards a more openness and more integration into the world system. Not as fast as many people would like, but it's heading that way. And if you look at it in the medium term, one very important plus for you, which you can take advantage of, is demographics. You talked about babies being a problem for the Indian politician. But in fact, because of the population trends, your workforce is a lot younger.
Sure.
I mean, your median age is about 27. The Chinese median age is now nearly 40. And the Chinese workforce, working age population, has already peaked.
Yes, yes.
So they will continue to grow, and significantly. But that demographic dividend is not going to be there. And after 15 years, you'll start to see the burden of an aging population. Whereas in India, you have a young population, and if you educate them and employ them productively, it's a tremendous plus for the country, for that generation, and maybe sometime longer. So that's one big plus for India, which we hope will be taken advantage of. Now, Southeast Asia and the tensions in the South China Sea, it worries us because we have been able to prosper in the last 20 plus years because the whole region has been peaceful, China has been developing, America has been here holding the peace, present, contributing economically and with soft power, and that has made a big difference to Southeast Asia. And the South China Sea has the potential of upsetting that. It may or it may not. The countries involved who are parties to it, I think, do not want it to cause a drastic upheaval in the status quo and do not want to collide and are trying their best not to collide. But there are interests at stake and it's not so easy to resolve the problem. So if it can be managed and tensions kept down and we just find ways to live and let live, then I think we can continue to develop and prosper. We've been in a similar position before. During the Cold War, Southeast Asia was on the front line. And it could have gone wrong, but fortunately the position held and we passed that phase and, sunshine broke out again and things were good for all of Southeast Asia. And we hope that we can maintain the position. But if it turns out that the clouds and the dark clouds come, we will have to find a way to navigate through the complexity. We have to do that.